Good morning everyone. The topic we are starting today is solubility of gases and solids in liquids. Okay, first of all, what is solubility? Okay, the solubility, the maximum amount of solute which can be dissolved in a specified amount of solvent. That one is known as solubility. Now, if the amount of a substance, okay, which is dissolved, if it is more, and it is more easily dissolved in a particular solvent, so it means its solubility is high. And if less amount is soluble in less amount of solute is soluble in more amount of solvent, so it means it is less soluble in that particular solvent. Now in this, okay, first thing is that one is factors affecting the solubility of a solid. Okay, in case of factors affecting the solubility of solid, so we have so many factors. Now first one is, that one is a very general factor, that is nature of the solute and the solvent. Nature of the solute and the solvent. Now in case of nature of solute and solvent, for this, okay, very important thing, and it's a line you can say, okay, that one is, if you remember one thing, so that you can easily identify how it affects the solubility. Okay, that one is very common. It's a like dissolves like. Okay, like dissolves like. Now like dissolves like means, okay, generally, you know, we are searching for a friends, those who are alike, whose habits are same. Okay, the same condition in solubility also. So like dissolves like means that polar solute, that one is polar solute, is soluble in polar solvent. Now just see, this one is polar solute is soluble in polar solvent. Now polar means, okay, in which we have ions, positive or negative ions generally. Okay, for example, in case of NaCl, it's a Na positive, Cl negative. It means two poles are there, so it is polar in nature. Okay, so it means that polar solute dissolve in polar solvent, and you know that NaCl is highly soluble in water because water is also polar. Okay, it's a partial positive and partial negative charges in case of H2O. If you remember, that one is hydrogen, this one is, okay, it's a H2O, it's a structure, this one is partial negative, this one is partial positive. Okay, so there is a polarity in water, that's why that polar solute is soluble in water, because like dissolves like. And non-polar solute dissolves in non-polar solvent. Okay, it means where, it means in those substances in which there is no positive or negative charge. Generally, they are present in the form of molecule, not in the form of ions. Okay, so that one is the non-polar solute dissolve in non-polar solvent. Okay, now second factor. Now just see, this one is one thing, like dissolves like, you have to remember this thing. This one is very important thing. Okay, now next one is, that is effect of temperature. Now just see, another one is, another factor. Okay, we have, that is effect of temperature. Now in case of effect of temperature, generally, you know, it's a your day-to-day life observation, okay, when we increase temperature, then solubility of solid increases. It's a general observation. Okay, now so this one is also same, that one is, as we increase temperature, then the solubility of solid increases. But okay, now we have two condition, okay, in this one. Okay, first condition is, okay, generally, if the solute dissolves with absorption of heat, okay, first thing is, okay, if solute dissolves with absorption of heat, the solubility increases with rise in temperature. Okay, that one is important thing. If there, it means if the reaction is endothermic reaction. Now just see, if the reaction is endothermic, basically endothermic means in which heat is absorbed. Okay, so in that case, that solubility, you can say in that case, solubility, okay, increases with rise in temperature. Increases with rise in temperature. Okay, that one. For this, we have so many examples. Okay, that one is NaNO3. Solubility increases. Ammonium chloride, it increases with temperature. KCl, NaCl, etc. Generally, their solubility increases with temperature. Now, in this one, second point. Okay, because this one is endothermic reaction, when reaction occur with absorption of heat. In that case, generally solubility increases with rise in temperature. Okay, but in case if the reaction is exothermic, okay, exothermic reaction. So in case of exothermic reaction means, okay, if the solute dissolves with evolution of heat. Okay, when you dissolve that solute, okay, so generally heat is evolved. Okay, so the solubility decreases with rise in temperature. Okay, this one is in exothermic reaction. That one is in exothermic reaction. Okay, that one is solubility. You can say that solubility decreases with rise in temperature. It means inversely proportional. More is the temperature, less is the solubility. And in case of endothermic reaction, it's a directly proportional. More is the temperature, more is the solubility. So it depends. Now, another thing is, third factor, that one is effect of pressure. That one is effect of pressure. Now, remember one thing, in case of solids, okay, generally, okay, very small or negligible effect of pressure. In case of solubility, okay, of solid and liquid, so the effect is very, very less, or either you can say it's negligible. Okay, now, the less effect, very small, either you can say very small effect or insignificant. Either you can say insignificant. Okay, so this one is regarding to effect of pressure, and this one is all the things regarding to factors affecting the solubility of solid. Now, solubility of gases in liquid, that I'll explain in again another video. Okay, thank you.